Tennessee Tech head coach Dwayne Alexander, the Golden Eagles, coming off a game where they lost at against nationally ranked UT Martin. They're going to conclude the regular season. They're going to go to in-state rival Austin Peay on Saturday. So, Coach, thoughts on your team, and then we'll go to some questions.
Well, you know, it's certainly a tough loss, homecoming loss, a senior day loss here at Tucker Stadium. And, you know, I tell you, very tough to see, an opposing team, you know, get to celebrate winning the OVC championship, you know, on your field. But well-deserved by UT Martin. They are the best team in the OVC. The outstanding team. I see no weaknesses. You know, quarterback is outstanding. He's not only a good football player, but he is you can tell an outstanding leader. He's really elevated that whole team. Big physical offensive line, good running game. We had a three and out early to start the game, had 11 play drive to start the game, and missed a field goal. We had the ball inside the 25 yard line three times, only come away with 3 points in the first half. And our Achilles heel, we had an interception, a couple of interceptions there, back to back, and it was a 21-3 game. We'd stopped them, had a big stop, forced them into a fourth and long, and roughed the punter and gave the ball back to them, and they were able to hit a big play right before half, and that really broke the game open. Just some plays that you can't make against any team, but certainly against a UT Martin, you can't have those. You need those type of breaks to go your way, not the other way. But we got Austin Peay this week on the road to finish. I'm proud of our guys. They come back, responded. Practice this week. Our issue has not been effort or playing hard. It's been playing well and playing consistent. And it's just hard to overcome certain plays that happen in a game. Turnovers, especially. We certainly work hard to not turn the football over, but we have not been able to consistently keep that from happening. So when you're not winning the turnover battle consistently every week, it's hard to consistently, win football games or to overcome that. You have to be exponentially better than the other team. And I don't know if there any team in the league can overcome the turnover situation that we've had. And that will be a key for us this week to go to Austin Peay and to compete and have an opportunity to win the game, is we're going to have to take care of the football better in that game. And I've been saying that every week, and we will practice hard this week. Again, I don't worry about the effort of our guys. I don't worry about how hard our guys are going to play. I never cross my mind. Our guys give great effort and they play hard, but we're not playing well enough right now to consistently win conference football games. And we got another week to try to go do that, on the road against an opponent that is playing outstanding and very talented. And we know that we got a big challenge.
Let's go to some questions, Van, from the Governor's Sports Network. If you want to go ahead, Van, sorry.
Coach, you had back-to-back wins against Southeast Missouri and NC Central and a solid win against Virginia Lynchburg. What were the keys to your success in those games?
Well, I mean, exactly what I just alluded to here in my opening statement, Van. Those were games that we were able to, the Southeast Missouri game, we were able to get an interception, there in the second half that when we were down 10-0, it gave us some momentum. We were able to score off of that interception, play some complimentary football. Right now, besides us turning the football over offensively, we're not creating a lot of turnovers, And in those games, the North Carolina Central game, we were able to create some turnovers. Southeast Missouri, we had the interception in the second half that gave us some momentum and gave us a score to kind of get our sideline going. And that's what those things do. When you create turnovers, you're the beneficiary of turnovers. We blocked a punt against North Carolina Central to set up a 1 yard run, to open the game. Games we've won, we've been able to, create some turnovers or big plays in the kicking game and defensively, and then take care of the ball ourselves, in games that we've lost. I mean, the Murray State game, we had 3 turnovers that contributed 15 points for them. We get beat 32-27, and we gave them 15 points. They had a pick six and a return to 2-point try for 100 yards for 2 points. And they stripped the ball, pulled it from our running back and ran it down to the 6. Our defense held them to a field goal. But you give a team 15 points, and then we created no turnovers ourselves. Our offense had to take it 74 yards, 76 yards, 73 yards, to try to score, and that's very hard against anybody to take and, drive the length of the field, 70 plus yards, to try to score all your touchdowns, trying to get some short field opportunities, whether it be through special teams, through some type of turnover, you know, to create some, you know, some field position where you don't have to take it the full length. And so, you know, games that we've had opportunities to win or that we have won and have been right there, you know, it's come down to that, that simple thing right there.
Of course, when you talk about turnovers, you know that the Governors lead the FCS in terms of interceptions and turnovers gained, 17 interceptions, 8 fumble recoveries, total of 25 turnovers gained this year. Again, that has to be a special concern for this weekend.
Well, thanks for reminding me of that, Van. Certainly a stat that I was well aware of, but I appreciate you bringing that back up. I was actually having a good morning. We'd had a good practice till you brought that back up. But, you know, certainly very aware of that. They're very active on defense. I mean, they bring guys from everywhere, you know, and all their guys can run. All their secondary guys, I mean, can really run. I mean, they really pursue the football and, you know, can just chase down things and really create some havoc. You know, their guys are excellent blitzers. You know, they can get pressure on the quarterback a lot of different ways. And then they have guys that, again, you know, a lot of times they'll, a lot like UT Martin, you know, they'll rush 3 and drop 8. They get you in a really long yardage situation. But all their guys can cover all that space so fast, you know, they do a really nice job. Anytime you're that active, you get your hands on a lot of footballs and, you know, things like that, you're going to create some turnovers. And they've done an outstanding job. And certainly, you know, in our 10 games we played, that's not something we've done a great, you know, ours all come from the quarterback position for the most part. I mean, we've had 23 turnovers at the quarterback position, either interceptions or fumbles. Our running backs and skill players, you know, they've all done a nice job of taking care of the ball. You know, we just got to, you know, do a better job of it there. And, you know, again, we know that we can do it. We've shown games that we can do it. We just haven't done it consistently.
Coach David Gifts, he can catch and he can run. And Quentin Cross has 40 receptions this year. Talk about the importance of these players to your offense.
Yeah, they're very important. You know, David really, as David goes, our offense goes. I've been very proud of him. You know, even last week, I mean, he had 23 carries for 70 yards. That was tough sledding in there, but he kept running hard, you know, finishing runs. I think he's up to, you know, 840 yards. He's averaging over 5 yards a carry. He had a string there of 4 straight games. He rushed for over 100 yards. And besides that, what you already alluded to, David is an outstanding catcher of the ball. I mean, he really, besides running the football, we try to get him the ball a lot of different ways in the passing game. He's very good catching the football and does some really good things with it, yards after catch, after he catches it. So, you know, he's certainly a focal point of our offense. And Quentin has really had an outstanding year. We always knew Quentin could be a, you know, really good player for us. And he's made some, boy, the Murray State game made some dynamic catches, you know, in that game. He's had 40 catches, you know, on the season for us. And in the same way, besides, he's one of those guys, besides catching the ball, we get him involved some other ways of getting the football, you know, as well in the run game some too. So both very good players, and we'll need those guys to play well to have opportunity to move the ball against Austin Peay.
Coach, last question. At the beginning of the season, you felt that this was perhaps the best defense that you had at Tennessee Tech. Talk about Josh Relaford and Seth Carlisle. They've combined for 126 tackles. Talk about your defense in general and these two players in particular.
Well, you know, Seth and Josh both are, besides being really good football players, are outstanding young men, you know, outstanding leaders, are both very active. Seth Carlisle was our Robert Hill Johnson Award winner in the spring season, which is our team MVP voted on by the teammates. And, you know, Seth's had a good fall as well. Josh Relaford had an excellent spring and has had an excellent fall. He's a preseason first team all-conference pick. You know, he's an excellent tackler. Both these guys prepare hard and play hard. We've been our defensive line, defensive front, you know, has played consistently and played well really all year. You know, we picked up some injuries as the season has gone here in the secondary that has hurt us a little bit. Our depth, secondary wise, we've lost a couple of corners and a safety, for the year, but our guys have continued to play hard there, you know, and play solid, you know, again, you know, last week, we started off the game solid, but, you know, UT Martin up front, offensive line wise, they're outstanding, but I've been very proud of our defensive effort, you know, this season. And, you know, we've done some really nice things on there. The only thing that we haven't done that I would love to see us do more is create more turnovers from a defensive standpoint. But Seth and Josh both have had outstanding seasons this year. And we're excited about having both of those guys back next year.
Well, Coach, as always, I appreciate your time and your answers to the questions that I have. And I also appreciate your work with the Ethical Conduct and Sportsmanship Committee with the NCAA. That has not gone unnoticed, at least from my seat. So appreciate that very, very much.
Thank you, Van. Just appreciate all you guys that cover, you know, our guys and cover teams. And, you know, and I just appreciate your professionalism. I really do. Thank you.
Thank you, Coach.
Coach, thanks for your time this morning and best luck in this final game. And thanks for your time all season long on these conference calls.
Appreciate it, Kyle. Thank you.
Have a good one.